Hey, Michelle, how's it going today?
Hey, Lindsay, good. How are you?
Good. Hey, I have a question for you.
All right.
Is today's episode rocket science?
Interesting. I don't think it's rocket science, but it does contain an expression about rocket science that we are going to clear up for you today. This is going to be a fun one to talk about things that aren't that hard.
Yes, that's the key. How to say that something is not that hard. So guys, go ahead and hit subscribe right now to get more episodes like this on this YouTube channel. And Michelle, let's go ahead and get started.
Okay, enjoy.
Hello, Michelle. How's it going today? How's everything?
Hey, Lindsay. Good, good, good. How are you? I'm excited to see you on video.
I know. It's good as always. Always fun doing a little YouTube action here. Guys, go and check out today's episode. It's over on the All Ears English YouTube channel and make sure you hit subscribe there. Michelle, I'm happy because I'm at the ocean this week. Yeah.
That's good. You're in your happy place.
I'm in my happy place. The smell of the ocean is the best thing in the world. How are you this week? What's going on? What's new?
Yeah, I'm good. I'm good. Everything is good. It's been hot as anything over here. But not too much exciting stuff. Just happy to be here. But Lindsay, do you think you'll be able to figure out how to send those files we talked about?
Well, I hope so, Michelle. I mean, it's not rocket science.
Oh, okay, good.
Our little role plays are always so funny.
I know. It's not rocket science. Lindsay, what did you mean by that?
What I meant by that is that it's not, you know, so hard. It should, at least it shouldn't be, right? It shouldn't be so difficult that I can't figure it out. What I think is funny is when sometimes you are talking about aeronautical engineering or science, when it actually is rocket science. I think that's the funniest thing.
I don't know if I included that. Oh, wait, no, I actually did. Never mind. I'll teach another expression later. You're probably thinking of it too.
Well, it's funny because, you know, I was just watching the news with my parents here last night where Jeff Bezos just did his big rocket launch right to space. What are your thoughts on that, Michelle?
I haven't followed it too much, but I did see something that was like, you know, he's going to space for 5 minutes and that's like the time of a break for an Amazon employee.
I know. I this one's hitting me not in a great way. Yeah. I just think it's a weird moment to be doing it. And I think the angle he's taking is environmental science, just awareness of the environment and climate change. But what's his plan? Is he going to send everyone to the moon or to outer space so we can see the planet and how destroyed it is? Like what, how is this actually going to change climate change? Right? How is this going to help our environmental efforts? Right? I'm having a hard time connecting the dots of what the point is.
Yeah, I know. Well, actually I saw an interview, you know, Neil deGrasse Tyson.
Yeah, I've heard of him.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Oh, he's amazing. And he said almost like he doesn't even believe that they officially went into space. Like, cause they like him and Richard Branson, like they just went like a tiny bit up and it's like not even like really considered anything. So I'm not really sure.
Yeah.
I don't really understand it basically. It,
and also in the midst of the whole conversation we're having around workers' rights, hourly wages, respect for workers, it's just a weird time to be spending all this money on going to space.
Yeah.
And then I'm thinking, when I was listening to the news lesson, I'm thinking, is he trying to carve a way for us to go to a new planet to live? Like, is that the climate change plan? Like to actually escape the Earth? You know, I don't know. These guys think so big, which I respect how big they think, but it's a weird time for this. Yeah.
Right. It is. Yeah. So yeah, I don't know. Well, guys, we're talking about rocket science today. but no, I'm glad you brought it up. It's an interesting thing that we'll be following.
It's really interesting.
Guys, this expression is a very popular one. I mean, I think Jessica taught it a little bit on IELTS. So guys, if you search for it in the search bar, you might find it a little bit on an IELTS video or podcast. So
good. But,
wanted to bring it to All Ears English today. I mean, Lindsay, what do you think of this expression? Do you use it? What do you think it implies? Yeah.
I think it's great. It's a classic. Guys, this is classic natural English and idiom. It just means it's not that hard, right? It's not rocket science. It's not complicated. We should be able to do it. I think it's interesting. I mean, the more color you guys can add to your language, the more you're going to connect. So we love to share these expressions with you.
Definitely love it. So guys, before we get more into this, we want to remind you that we have our All Ears English app. We are on iOS and Android, right, Lindsay?
I know. It's so exciting that now we're on Android and hundreds of students are signed up with the plan there. They're subscribed. So they are seeing transcripts every time they listen to Allers English and they are choosing their keywords. That's what's unique about this app is that you can actually select keywords to make your own power list that you want to remember. I would imagine, Michelle, rocket science will be one of them for this episode.
I imagine it will. Yeah, guys. So go on over to AllersEnglish.com/app to get that.
Totally. And guys, remember, we also do have an IELTS podcast. Michelle, just a few minutes ago, you mentioned IELTS. That is the IELTS Energy podcast. If you're taking IELTS anytime in the next year or two, you definitely want to subscribe to that one. All right?
For sure. Love it. So yeah, this expression, we'll talk about like when you would use it. I think it shows a lot of personality. And I think it could go in two ways. I think it could give someone confidence, right? Like that you can do it, that you are able to complete a task that maybe you think is hard. But I could also see it as being like a little condescending. What do you think, Lindsay?
I agree, Michelle. I think that's a good point. It depends on, I like any of these expressions, guys. It depends on how you use it. What's your tone of voice?
Yeah.
What's the context? Just make sure we're not saying this. You know, if someone's struggling with something and you come in and they ask you for help and you say, oh, it's not rocket science. Why can't you do this? Obviously, that's going to degrade your connection with the person, right? We know
right,
that.
Exactly. Like we have this little role play. Like, okay, you know, listen and see if you guys think it's like nice or kind of rude. Okay. okay, Lindsay, have you figured out the software?
No, I'm still struggling.
It's not rocket science.
Yeah. And that's just annoying and tacky when people use these expressions to kind of make people feel bad, right? That's just a personality thing. I mean, if that's your personality, then you do you, right?
You know, exactly. We should do a whole episode about the expression you do you.
You do you. It's such a good one, Michelle. We have
that's
to do
a good
that
one. All right. Yeah. I'm going to put that in the idea.
No. Okay. On the list.
But it doesn't always have to feel rude, like Lindsay said. I mean, I think it could be good if it's like a joke about yourself, or maybe you're explaining something that's very easy to everybody and it's kind of funny, right? So let's do a little example.
Okay, here we go. Ah, why can't I get this right?
What?
This spreadsheet, I mean, it's not rocket science. Actually, Michelle, I think sometimes spreadsheets are rocket science. I mean, I had to have someone help me with our, with the, like making pivot table. There, spreadsheets can get really crazy and very technical.
True.
And I'm lacking a lot of Excel skills.
Sometimes I think it's like if you're the one just using the spreadsheet, you know, but if you have to build something and it's very complicated, it is a little like rocket.
It's like I need a business degree or a finance degree to make those tables work.
No, I think it is like there's a whole art to it.
There really is. So guys, you know, but I bet a lot of our listeners do work in spreadsheets all the time. So for them, hopefully it's not rocket science. Do we have another role play, Michelle?
Exactly. Exactly. Let's try this one.
All right, Michelle, click that button.
Oh, that one?
Yeah.
Will I remember this next time?
Well, I'm sure you will. It's not rocket science.
Okay. So I think the way you said it, I think it was almost like reassuring. So with that kind of tone of voice in that way, it could be really nice to say that.
Okay. So it just really depends on your tone. And that's what matters in the end. You know, that's our message at Allers English is it's the way you say things. It's how you're supporting the speaker, how you're building the connection. It's not really the words you use. Right.
Right. Right. Right. Exactly. I think it's a good expression. I think it's fun. I think it's a unique way to say something.
Yeah. Agreed.
But here's the other one that I was thinking about earlier. And I was like, I hope I put that on. And of course, here's a whole thing about it. What's this expression?
So the expression, it's not brain surgery. So these are probably the two hardest careers, rocket science and brain surgery.
Ooh,
I could never be, you know, I did spend a little time this week in the hospital. My dad was in the hospital, but luckily he had heart surgery and he came through it really well, guys. So that's fantastic to report. But I will say that I spent a lot of time this week doing visits to the hospital and I do not like hospitals. God, they have a smell to them. I could never work in medical. I don't know.
No, me too.
The pressure. Unbelievable.
Well, we're glad to hear he's doing well. And
thank you.
Yeah, I mean, this expression, it's pretty much the same idea, right? It's not brain surgery. Yeah. I think that this one can be used also in a slightly different way as like, because brain surgery is also so, I mean, well, so is rocket science, but like brain surgery is so much like life and death that sometimes I've heard this in a way of like, you know, if you're like worried about something like, oh, it's not like you're doing brain surgery. It like almost like kind of when you're stressed about something it's, and you think, oh, I made a mistake. Sometimes I feel like I've heard people say like, you know, it's not like a mistake and a small mistake is going to kill someone, you know?
Exactly.
That's okay, unless it does, but
unless it does, but most of the time, like in our field, I've thought about that before. Like, I think I chose the right world because if we make a mistake as teachers, no one's going to die, right? No one's going to die. I mean, I just couldn't handle a job where the slightest mistake, someone could lose their lives. It's just not my personality, but thank God for the amazing healthcare workers we have.
Yeah.
Right. When I went to visit my dad on Thursday in the hospital, came off the flight from Colorado, went straight to the hospital. I felt so much gratitude for that nurse. It was amazing. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I completely agree. But yeah, I couldn't deal with that type of pressure. You have to really be a special kind of person who's okay with that. And some people are, and some people aren't, and that's okay. But like, you know, I could, no.
Not for us, Michelle.
Not me.
But if you guys are working in the medical field.
In the other way, it is similar to the rocket science.
It is similar.
Idea. So let's do a role play. Okay.
All right, here we go. So you'll take the 6 train and then you'll transfer at Grand Central.
Oh, I'm nervous.
Oh, Michelle, you can figure it out. It's not brain surgery. Okay. Sometimes navigating Grand Central can feel like brain surgery at rush hour.
I know. Well, I remember when my friend moved to New York and I had been living, you know, in New York for a while already. And it's easy to forget how confusing it can be.
Yeah.
If you're not used to it. So I remember my friend was like, oh, like, how do we get here? And I'm just like, you know, at first I wanted to be like, no, it's not, like, just like follow directions. It's fine. But there's something about the New York subway system and the buses that it is intimidating. It can be.
But I mean, Michelle, you've been to Japan. So you've seen the big stations like Shibuya, Shinjuku, Ginza. I remember when we did our live event with Allers English in 2018, I packed way too big of a bag for 4 days in Tokyo. And I remember being in Shinjuku at rush hour. And I knew Shinjuku because I lived in Japan, but I was up against a pole and I was just almost panicking. I was like, oh, I can't move. People are going everywhere around me and I have this huge bag. That kind of felt like brain surgery, trying to figure out where to go.
I remember with the trains in Japan, what was very helpful was the people who worked there. I would literally sometimes go up and there would be like a man or a woman standing, you know, right by where you would enter. And I would say the station name and they would just like put up the number of fingers of like what track I should be going on.
Yeah.
And or say it or whatever. And it was so helpful. Like in New York, like,
oh God,
that doesn't happen like so efficiently or at all. Like there's not always somebody sitting at the stand, you know? So I found that really helped.
Oh my gosh. In New York, if there is someone sitting in that little house, that little mini house, as you go out, they'll yell at you.
Yeah, I know. It's scary. Like, how do I get? Yeah, I know. So I appreciated that about Japan.
I love it.
So,
I love that.
But guys, this is in general a way to talk about things being, you know, easy. And those two phrases have a lot of personality.
Absolutely.
Lindsay, what are some other kind of simple ways to say this that don't have as much personality but are still nice and easy?
Right. It's always good to have just a more descriptive, straightforward way to say it, guys. So write these down. So you could say this: it's actually really easy, or it's actually really simple. Right. Mm-hmm. So using actually, Michelle, what's the function of that there in that phrase?
It's like, oh, you may not think this, but it's like, believe it, you know, surprise, you know.
It might be a surprise. Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Yeah. What else, Michelle? Is there another we can?
You could say, you can figure it out, like, in a nice way, in a nice way. You know, if somebody says, like, I don't know how to get to the state, oh, you can figure it out. It'll be fine. You know, like, things like that to reassure.
And I also could imagine saying this to a kid. Like, I just spent the last week with my niece and, like, you know, she's 8 and it's, like, empowering her to figure things out on her own. Like, hey, like, how do we get there? You can figure it out. You do it.
Yeah.
Right? So, but it also works when we're talking to adults, guys. So it's not just for kids.
It does too.
Yeah.
And then what's the last one?
It's easier than it seems. Maybe we should do an episode someday on the word seem, right? Because that's an interesting one. It's kind of a weird verb. then it, what would be seems, another verb yeah, that means the yeah, same yeah, thing? Yeah,
that seems like a good idea, Lindsay.
Yeah, like it appears, right? The word seem is like appear. That seems like a good idea. I'm glad you approve.
Yes, 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 exactly. So guys, these are all useful. Like these ones aren't quite as colorful as the other ones, but sometimes you want that extra personality and sometimes you just need the basics. So we wanted to give you both today.
Exactly. It's great when you have both. So guys, if you're on the app, make sure you are listening in the app. Everyone can now use it on iOS or Android. There's no block for anyone at this point. So sign up for the 7-day free trial. You'll be able to see transcripts for every regular episode, and then you'll be able to select the words you want to save in your personal list. So good. Exactly. So good. Good. Michelle, where
all right,
can
they... Lindsay, this has been fun. So, I mean, guys, the takeaway for today is these are all useful expressions. Make sure you're not using them in an insulting tone, unless that's how you want to be. And sometimes that's how people are. But listen for them and just think about that idea of like reassuring someone, or, you know, that moment, like maybe it could be even at work if, you know, you're learning something and, you know, you have all these steps and somebody can be like pretty intimidated or overwhelmed. And these kind of expressions can be helpful.
Yes, so. I love it. So good, Michelle. So good. And guys, go to allersenglish.com/app to get the app. And Michelle, we'll see you on the next one.
All right. Bye, Lindsay. Have a good one.
Take care. Bye.
Bye.